Willis was the aggressor in rounds 2 through 7 and is a head-on point here in round 8. A dynamite right sends Bella crumbling to the canvas. The referee sends Willis to a neutral corner and picks up the count. Braddock is out cold from that ponderous right hand. It's all over. Joe Louis scores a devastating eastbound knockout over Jimmy Braddock to win the heavyweight championship of the world. It's June 28th, 1939. Heavyweight champion of the world, Joe Louis, makes his 7th defense of his title against two-ton Tony Galanto. Louis in the white striped trunks knocked out Jack Roper just 8 weeks ago in defense of his world title. Here in round 2, Louis really opens up on Galanto, ripping deadly combinations to Galanto's head and body. A left hook and Galanto goes down. Louis's combinations are sharp and accurate, as Galanto is finding out. Galanto is a rough-and-tumble fighter bragging that he trained on spaghetti and beer. Watch as Galanto gets a short, powerful left hook off, and Louis goes down. The proud champion gets up almost immediately. Louis knocked out John Henry Louis, the light heavyweight champion in the first round 5 months ago. He is a fighting heavyweight champion and won't give up his coveted title without a battle. Galanto is 30 years old. He's been fighting professionally for 10 years. Joe Louis at 25 is 200 pounds of solid dynamite with knockout punching power in either hand. In 42 professional fights, Joe has lost only one, and that was to Max Foley in 1936. But Joe avenged his loss just last year when he scored a crushing one-round knockout over the Black Hewlin. Joe called it his most precious victory. Here in round 4 against the tough, rough Tony Galanto, Joe Louis is looking for a KO. Galanto begins to tire. Joe Louis measures his man, setting him up with short left to the body and right uppercut. Galanto really taking it. Championship in June 1937, 2 years ago, with an 8th-round knockout of champion Jimmy Braddock in Chicago. He's a fighting champion. Galanto beginning to get arm-weary. Joe Louis measures his man. It's June 20th, 1940. Joe Louis makes the 11th defense of his world heavyweight crown against rugged Arturo Godoy. Godoy wearing dark trunks with white stripes. Lewis in his familiar trunks with the initials JL. In February, 5 months ago, Joe took a 15-round decision over Godoy in defense of his heavyweight crown. This is the second meeting of these two fighters here in the seventh round. Joe Lewis getting off those deadly combination punches. Godoy goes down after a barrage of punches by Joe Lewis. That one knockdown slows up Godoy. Joe Lewis comes out for round eight full of confidence. Godoy up to now has been an elusive target, fighting out of a crouch and forcing Lewis to punch down. But now Godoy is standing erect, with Lewis ripping short right uppercuts to the head and damaging punches to the body. Combinations like Joe Lewis. Watch as he measures his man, sets him up. Godoy is up with a count of eight. Now the Brown Bomber goes to work with his famous combination. Godoy trying to tie the champion up. A dynamite right by Joe Lewis, and Godoy goes down like a ton of bricks. He is hurt. The referee stops the fight, but Godoy wants to continue. His hand was trying to hold him back. He rushes at Joe, and Joe puts up his hand, ready for anything. Now here in slow motion, let's watch that knockout sequence again. Joe Lewis once again proves he's the greatest heavyweight fighter of his generation as he scores a crushing eighth-round KO victory over the rugged South American Arturo Godoy. Joe Lewis continued to build the legend of the great Brown Bomber in this golden age of boxing. It's July 18, 1951. World heavyweight champion Ezard Charles in dark trunks defends his title against the number one contender, Jersey Joe Walcott. Challenger Walcott is wearing white. For the first six rounds, the champion Charles built up a slight lead in the scoring. Here in round seven, the hard-hitting Walcott will be looking for an opening. Tonight's fight is Charles' eighth defense of the heavyweight championship. Just 6 weeks ago, Charles took a unanimous 15-round decision from light heavyweight champion Joey Maxim in defense of his heavyweight title. Challenger Jersey Joe Walcott has been fighting professionally since 1930, 21 years ago. Joe, at 37, is giving away 6 years to the younger champion. Now watch Walcott in white trunks. A devastating left hook. Charles goes down. The referee picks up the count. Ezard is very hurt. It doesn't look like he's going to make it. It's all over. Now, in slow motion, let's see that punch again. Jersey Joe Walcott, in white trunks, steps in and times that punch perfectly. Look at the expression on champion Charles' face. Ezard crumbles to the canvas. Jersey Joe Walcott scores a crushing seventh-round KO victory over the Cincinnati Flash. Ezard Charles to become the new heavyweight champion of the world. Joe's cornermen congratulate him on his victory. Ezard's handlers try to revive their fighter.